Hey guys, I have the new yoga for the weekend. We haven't done yoga in a while. It's been like over a month. So today we're gonna just focus on more just stretching and really helping ease any sore muscles and just really working through tension and just making our muscles feel good. It's gonna be more about just getting a good stretch in for a release in the muscles. I'm really sore. I've been working really hard this week and I really need it. So we're gonna get a good stretch in and not do so many challenging and crazy poses. So let's get to it. All right, so we're gonna start with three sun salutations to warm up and do a couple standing poses and then start stretching everything out. Start my timers. Okay. So arms up overhead. Hands in front of your feet. Look at your knees. Up in the flat back. Hands in front of your feet. Jump or step back to plank. Forward. Chaturanga push up. Tuck your feet. Roll forward. Upward dog. Tuck your toes. Hips up, downward dog. Jump your feet to your hands. Straighten your legs, look at your knees, and reverse the movement. That's one, two more. Arms up overhead, hands in front of your feet, look at your knees, up and flat back, hands in front of your feet. Jump back to plank, forward, push up, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog. Oh, get a good stretch through the back of your legs, your hamstrings, and through your shoulders. You can do a little press, and get your head behind your arms a little bit more if you can. Really opens up the shoulders. Alright, jump back. Legs straight, look at your knees. Reverse the movement. Alright, last one, and then we're gonna do warrior one. Arms up overhead, hands in front of your feet, look at your knees. Up and flat back. Hands in front of your feet, jump back to plank. Forward, push up, tuck your feet. Roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog. Jump your feet, straighten your legs, look at your knees, and reverse the movement. Alright, now we're going to do warrior one. So we're still doing a few more sun salutations to get through. We're gonna do warrior one, two, and three. And then we'll move on. Arms up overhead, hands in front of your feet, look at your knees, open the flat back, hands down, jump back to plank, shoulders a little bit in front of your wrists, push up, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog. Now, swing right leg up to the sky and bring between your hands, going straight forward, toes pointing forward, bring the left back foot down diagonally, rise up. You don't want to open your hips out to the side here, you want to be forward. Keep the back leg straight and strong. Hips forward, and arms up. I'm not sure how impeccable my form will be today. I don't have my usual good mirrored surface with this holiday camera placement, but I'm gonna do my best. Low. Try to get good stretch. imagine. I really feel this in my hip. Don't bring your shoulders up too high. Relax. Just up, forward. All right, one more deep breath. Okay. Hands up side of foot. Foot back. Oh. All right. Plank. Push up. Tuck your feet. Roll forward. Upward dog. Tuck your toes. Up. Downward dog. And swing the left leg up. Bring it between your hands. Toes pointing forward. Right foot goes back. Or stays back. Goes down at diagonal. 45 degree angle. Rise up again. Right leg straight and strong. Get a good. Oh, get your hips forward. I need to work on that right now. Hips forward. Forward. Get the front thigh parallel to the ground, 90 degree angle. Arms up. Back leg straight and strong. Side is tough. Oh, do your best. One more deep breath. Okay. Oh, bring your foot back. I'm really feeling this already, guys. Push up. Tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, downward dog. Now we're gonna do warrior two. So bring the right leg up again, or if you just did the right leg, do the left. Just keep alternating legs. Swing it through, right foot toes pointing forward, turn the left foot back and down out at a 90 degree angle from this foot. Your feet should make a little L. Okay. Now you really want to get 90 degree angle, 90 degree bend in the right front thigh now. Get it parallel to the ground. I hope I'm in it. I'm trying. Arms out straight, look over the right front arm. Try and get as deep as you can. Don't let the knee go out past the ankle, definitely not past the toes. More deep breath. Alright. Back. Right back. Oh. Plank. Push up. Tuck your feet. Roll forward. Upward dog. Tuck your toes. Hips up. Down dog. You're gonna see me struggling. Hear me moaning and groaning today because my muscles are very sore. And I'm really feeling the benefit and the challenge of these moves. Swing the left leg up. Or if you just did the left, do the right. Just keep switching legs. Alright, swing it between your hands. Toes going straight forward. Turn the back foot, the right foot, down, out, 90 degree angle. Rise up now. Again, get the left leg, front leg, down. Get the thigh parallel to the ground. Get a nice 90 degree angle here. Sink into it. Arms out and look over the left
front arm. I feel something in my arm. Nothing's there though. More deep breath. Oh, I'm really feeling it. Oh, can't even move. Okay. Back to plank. Forward, push up, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes. Oh, hips up, downward dog. You just gotta do warrior three. Swing it through, keep the left foot up, keep the heel up exactly as it is, rise up, and just come up into standing just on the right front leg. You can touch your toes for right now, just really root and ground yourself in the front leg. Push the hip back, get a strong, firm standing through your glute and your hip and thigh. And bring the left leg back and start to lean forward. Bring your arms into it, flex the back foot, and get as flat as you can. I like to get myself comfortable in the position first, really get good form feeling, and then add the arms. Oh, really tighten everything. And try it one more time. Comfortable standing on one foot, lean back into it, don't come leaning forward, push back almost like you're gonna sit back with your hips, but then just use that as the strength to lift this leg up. You'll see I'm pushing my hips back and it makes me strong and it puts the center of gravity back here instead of at my chest, so I don't collapse and don't feel like toppling or falling forward, because all the weight is situated back here. You really want to float like this. Oh, okay. So now, come back to the lunge. Oh, back to plank. Forward, push up, tuck your feet. Roll forward, upward dog. So, toes, hips up, downward dog. And we're just gonna do this on the other side and then we're done with the standing sequences. Left leg up. Swing through, stay in this lunge position. Rise up. And come up to standing on the left leg now. Root. And ground yourself here. Get comfortable. Push your hips back like you're trying to sit back, but with your legs straight. And bring the right leg back. See you. Okay, get comfortable. Get comfortable. Tighter than my other one. Oh, we're gonna get into it again, because that is not long enough. Okay. comfortable standing on this leg. Come on, you can do this. You can do it. That was a little better. So now, back into the lunge again. Oh, okay, bring the foot back to plank. And last on salutation, push up, tuck your feet, roll forward, upward dog, tuck your toes, hips up, down dog. Oh. Shoulderstand. So, you can sit down on your butt, get back, bring your feet close to your hips, close to your butt. You're gonna lift your hips up, and you can, if you want to get a deeper stretch, you can walk your arms underneath your shoulders and clasp your hands and really rise up. This gets your shoulders involved and back involved and deeper stretch. Just really press up. If it's too much, just keep your arms like this and just keep pushing up, tightening your glutes. Just push, push, hold. Just keep holding this. Next, I'm gonna go up into wheel. If wheel's too challenging, just stay like this and bridge again. Maybe try the shoulder one that I just showed you. And try to hold that while I hold wheel. All right, lower down. Now for wheel, it's the same thing. Well, similar. It's a deeper back bend. So you're gonna lift the hips up again. But this time you're gonna take your hands, roll them back, and the fingers are gonna be pointing towards your shoulders. You can place them beside your ears, not cupping close to your face, but comfortably shoulder the same width as your shoulders, because you want them to be underneath your shoulders, you know, so you can stand up in a way that makes sense for your body. Okay, so you lift up through the hips first. You can stay in bridge or come with me, hands underneath your fingers just underneath your shoulders, hands next to your ears. Press through the hands. Oh, rise up. Oh. I walked my hands closer to my feet than you should if you're not comfortable. Don't overdo it. It might feel like it's okay right now, but later your back is gonna hurt. So be careful. Mine probably is too. I'm gonna ease out of that a little bit. Okay. And just press through the hands with strength. Just keep holding, tightening your glutes, pressing through your hands and your feet. One more deep breath because I'm really feeling it. Bend the elbows, lower the shoulders, let the hips. Oh. You don't want to stay in that past the point at which you feel stable and like you can come out of that with control, because you never want to collapse out of that movement, out of that position. Oh, we gotta do plough now. Plough is wonderful. Arms at your sides. Lift your hips up and feet over the head on the ground. Oh, yeah. I feel this a little bit in my shoulders today though, because you kind of use and rest on
your traps, your trapezius, and deltoids, and all those other wonderful upper back muscles that I really strained or really worked the last few days. And from here, I'm gonna put my hands on my back and I'm gonna raise up into shoulder stand. You can just stay here, or if you wanna come in and out of plough, you know, come out for a minute, lay down, just flat on your back and get back into it. That's cool. That's cool, guys. Or if you wanna try to practice, you know, bring your leg up a little bit, just messing with plough, just be careful. I'm gonna put my hands on my back, thumbs to my sides. Is that how I do it? Now I'm doubting myself. Yeah, that's how you do it. I'm gonna start walking them. Bring the legs up. Bring my elbows in. I wanna make a good standing point on my shoulders, really get the neck comfortable. You don't want to stand on your neck for this. And have the chin in the chest, tucked in. Walk your hands as high up your back as is good for you to feel comfortable in this position. It's very hard for me to tell where my legs should be. I always hold them up too high, leaning towards my face. Maybe this looks a little better. Try not to jam your thumbs. I'm jamming mine a little bit right now. Really tight the glutes. You go straight back. Get as straight as you can. Forehead. You come back to plough. We're just bringing these forehead slowly, slowly. Roll out. Oh. Hope my form wasn't garbage. Shoulder stand is something I'm working on. It's challenging. It feels good. Just haven't been able to get the form that pretty, but that's why I'm working on it. Keep working on it to get stronger and better and more comfortable with it. What do we got next? Ooh, we were doing the wide standing forward bend with shoulder stretch. So, do this diagonal. Get your feet wide apart. I'm gonna clasp your hands behind your back. If you can't keep your hands, your palms together, you can have them apart like this. So clasp them behind your back. Bend forward, stick the arms out. Press your shoulder blades together there, don't let this just hang. Stick the arms out. Shoulder blades together. Lean forward and, or bend forward, excuse me, and really try to just let gravity help your shoulders to open here and to let your hips open too. It's great because you're working on your shoulders while you're stretching out your hamstrings, your legs here. It's like a total body stretch. Oh, for the price of one. Doing it all at one time. I like to move a little bit in it. Get a little bit of fluidity in the movement, in the motion. Motion in the ocean. But if you don't like that, don't do it. Do whatever you want to do. And too, if you can't keep your hands together, you're going to put them apart like this. You can get them together. You don't have to clench them tight either. Just hold them, just like your hands are comfortably folded in your lap. And just allow them to open and move closer to the floor. I really need this stretch. My shoulders are just wrecked. Really been hitting it hard this week. We need this yoga. We need this stretch. Alright, I'm not gonna hold it too much longer. This is just one that you need to spend, you know, more than 30 seconds in. Otherwise, you don't really give it the proper time to work with gravity to allow the nice opening, stretching movement. You gotta be patient with ones like this. And just breathe through it. Alright, one more deep breath. Alright, bring the hands back down to your butt. And you can release, undo them. Bring them between your feet. Slowly start to raise up. What are we doing next? Oh, pigeon. Alright, let's put it together. Slowly. Comes back up. Alright. Now, pigeon. So you want to get into downward dog first for this, just to get a good positioning for the movement. Yep. Down dog. Swing leg up. Either one. I'm doing the right, so bring the right knee to the right wrist. Bring your left leg back. Try to get yourself your hips grounded here. Turn the left foot in towards the body, the toes pointing in, and really get the hips down to the ground so that you're just really rooting through pelvis close to the ground as possible, so you're getting as deep and comfortable in this movement as you can. If you need some more time with this, you can move forward and breathe into it. I'm gonna stay up and lift up the back left leg, grab it with my left hand and pull it in. And you can do mermaid, let your foot go against your upper arm. Enjoy this easier modification of the king pigeon. This feels really nice and it looks pretty graceful. And if you want to try to go deeper, keep working on opening up this hip, bringing the knee in. It's the legs that don't have as much flexibility for me, the hips rather. I can get the back flexibility to do the king pigeon. Reach over with my right hand. Oh. Oh.
down. Whoa, get back into down dog. Up. And left leg up. Bring the left knee to the left wrist. Again, get very comfortable. Get your hips into this. Hips down into the ground. Pelvis down towards the right leg. Comfortable, get the right toes turned in towards the body. Get bent forward. Still, which I do. Kel loves orange soda. Hope someone knows Keenan and Kel. Too young for that, too old for that. Alright, just keep pulling gently, letting this come to the knee, keep bending and pulling the foot closer to the body. Catch it with the left. Oh no, not yet. Let's see if I can touch. Backbending. Alright. Into cobra, and then I'm gonna get into the full cobra, bringing my feet to my head. Don't have to do that. You could even just stretch a little bit, you know, get as close as you can, just get that, just to get comfortable trying to feel that movement. So put your hands underneath your shoulders, and rise up, really pressing your pubic bone, the pelvis, to the ground. I mean, I shouldn't be saying pelvis, pubic bone. You know, your groin. That big old bone. Oh. I always move my hands back to get, just to give me a better base to really press through my hands. Back bend, but I guess I don't really need to. Feels like I can bend anyway. Feet. Back. And if you can't, you can just get, you know, just kind of, just bend. Bend them up and bend back. See what you can do. I think for me, it's more people, I think you try to push the feet towards the head, but you really want to bend your back. And then you just bring your feet up and they just meet your head. Because it's all coming from the back. The back is where the flexibility is in the spine. Child's pose for a second. Alright, and now you're seated forward bend, just as a K. counter pose to the back bends. So get your feet out straight in front of you.
Your legs and your feet out straight. Flex the feet, toes pointed up,
and straight back. Jump and reach through. Really keep your legs straight. One more deep breath. Alright. And lay on your back. We're going to do fish. To extended leg fish. So get your hands. You're going to put them together underneath your butt. And rise up on your forearms. So thumbs touching. Put them underneath your butt cheeks. Down straight. Just as far down as your hands go, or as your arms go, flat, put them underneath your body. For me, it's underneath my butt. If yours go up a little higher, that's good. If they go lower, it's just wherever your arm length goes on your body. We are all different. It's probably somewhere relatively around your butt, though, I would think. And if not, then you're really cool, so it's all good. Okay. So now, raise up forearms, and you can keep your head like this. I like to raise up really high, I think it feels really good. And just hold this. If you're down here, stay like this too, that's good. And I'm gonna come up into it again and do the extended leg fish, because I really like how that feels. Alright, now you can come up into the fish again, or you can do the extended leg fish with me. So again, bring your hands underneath your body, and now I'm gonna stay on my head. Rise up on my head, crown of my head. Bring my arms out, and bring my legs and my arms up. And breathe. Arms next to me to pull out of it. And down. Alright. Locust. I can't really roll in and out of this. I'm going to go off camera video. But you get on your side, cup your hands together, one hand over the other, like you're showing somebody how to punch, and thumbs out, and you put it between your legs again, just down as far as your arms go, and you're gonna roll on top of it, and use your hands underneath you as the base to propel yourself up. I gotta adjust myself all weird. Okay. Butt wiggle and butt dance. Just get yourself stable and comfortable to have a good strong base to rise up with, to get a good strong locust. This feels good. Okay. You can also raise one leg at a time to prep. I don't want to do that right now. I want to get all the strength generated and power up. I'm ready. And your chin should be against the ground. Ready.
Hold it as long as you can. Okay. That felt strong. I hope it was like relatively high. You can never tell with locust. It always feels like it's weak. And then I go back and look at the video and it's pretty good. Eventually you're supposed to be able to get higher, 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 and then your feet come down on your head. That's gonna look cool. I hope we get there someday. Now we're doing deep squat into garland. You can hang out in deep squat if you can't do garland. I like to start in deep squat. So get your feet a little bit wider than shoulder width apart. Squat down. I should do this at squat down, deep squat. Really ground through the hips. Really like you're sitting down, like almost like sitting on your heels. Like see, this is comfortable. I could stay like this for a very long time until my legs give out, which would probably be at least 5-10 minutes. My hips are very open in this position. But a lot of people, you're gonna struggle with the hips up. The hips up and the heels up. So just work on using your hands and helping yourself to sit back, because you really want to sit back more so that you're standing comfortably through the whole foot. The heels are down on the ground. Keep working on this. Keep working on getting your heels down. And if you're comfortable here, like me, then you're going to bring your feet, walk them together. Again, stand through the whole foot, through the toes and the heels, and sit back. Get as low as you can, as deep as you can, and put your arms down. You can bring them back. I keep trying to get the full expression going around my back like this. I've gotten a little further, but I still can't quite move my hands, but I'm gonna keep working on it. And you just keep working on opening up these hips and just rest here. Forearms, forearms back. Just standing through the whole foot. Make sure you're not coming forward onto your toes. You're standing equally through the whole foot, through the heels, the middle of the foot, and the toes. We're almost done. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. I'm gonna try splits next. Oh, that should be interesting. We better hold this for a minute to really open up the hips. Otherwise, I don't know if we're gonna be able to do it. But we're working on it. The flexibility is different every day. It's changing every day, so. Interesting. Alright. I'm just gonna try. So get down. Bring forward. I can already feel not happening. Well, close.
it without holding it.
Not today.
See, because this would be the perfect or near perfect position. I can't get quite into it.
Alright, try the other side.
This is my tighter side, so. Alright. Keep your hips square. It's hard. Okay. All right, we tried. Now we're just gonna do one balance pose, and then we're just gonna do two final stretches. Down on the ground. So, we're gonna do Lord of the Dance. Stand on your left foot. Grab the right foot with your right hand around the outside. Well, you grab from around the outside to underneath. So, you're grabbing the inside of the foot. And put your arm forward. Your left arm straight forward like this. You're going to stand comfortably. Again, root yourself through your hips. But this time, start pushing back with the right leg to help bring yourself back. And then you're going to naturally come forward the more you press out and up with the right leg. And really focus. Pushing back, not forward. Oh, I didn't want to fall out of that, and I did because I'm thinking about it. Okay, back into it. I'm going to do it again, I'm going to do it without talking. There we go. Oh, that took a while to find. Okay. You really want to push back, up, and out through the back leg, and then start to hinge forward at the hips so that you have the base going backward again. Because you really want to have all the strength back here so you're not just toppling forward over this one little leg holding you up. All right. So now stand on the right leg. From the outside of the left leg, grab the left foot, and the same thing, right arm out straight, but ground yourself, keep the right leg straight, pushing back, up and out, and you want to like arch the back too, kind of pull your chest up as you're doing it. That helps a lot. I'm doing something not right. Keep trying. Get comfortable. Okay.
Best I can do.
It's not easy today.
Alright.
I'm gonna sit down. Do one leg forward bend. So bring your left leg out straight. Right leg, bring the right foot into the left thigh. Pressed against it. Get the left leg straight. Sit up straight. Reach through. Doing this, and then we're gonna do a laying spine twist and corpse, and we're out of here. I think it's gonna be under an hour.
We really needed this though. We really needed this long, good, deep stretching. I hope you are feeling good with it too.
Left foot presses in against your right thigh. Right leg straight. And back straight. And forward. Pull on the foot. Really make sure there's no bend in the knee. It's as flat against the ground as it can be. Let's really get a good deep stretch through the leg. One more deep breath. All right. Legs, spinal twist. All right. This is the actual greatest. It feels so amazing. I hope I'm like relatively on camera. I don't know. Hopefully you know what it looks like. You have your legs out straight. Bring one knee to your chest. Right knee to the chest. Bring it over to the left side. Down on the ground, your right arm goes out straight to the right, and you want to get the right shoulder pressing into the ground as you press the right knee into the ground on the left side, and you twist through both, and you just keep breathing and twisting through both, and it feels amazing in your back. So just breathe into this for a minute. This is one of the most effective and relaxing stretches. It's just relieving so much tension, pressure in your muscles. Sometimes if I haven't cracked my back yet, it helps you crack your back in a really nice and natural and not painful way. It's amazing. Keep twisting, pressing through the shoulder. Alright, other side. Okay. Back, flat on your back. Legs out straight, bring the left knee in. Bring it over to the right side, down on the ground. And the left arm goes out straight to the left. And again, twist through the left knee and pressing the left shoulder into the ground. And the left knee into the ground. Just twist through both, looking to the left with the left arm. Stretching, pressing, twisting. One more deep breath. All right. Oh, back. And we're done. Corpse. Oh, so just lay comfortably flat on your back.
Relax everything from your head to your toe. And you just hang out here as long as you want. I get restless and don't like to hang out here for too long, but I'm gonna try to do at least a minute. It's important. Breathing, centering, just feeling relaxation in this moment. Ignore my sneeze. I'm gonna come out of it. Slowly.
Oh, 56 minutes. So, wasn't too crazy long. We did a lot. We did a lot for this workout. So, that was pretty good for how much that was. This felt really good, really relaxing. I feel nice and stretched out. That felt necessary and a little bit challenging just because my muscles are hurting. They're hurting me. So, you know, I hope it felt good for you. Hope it was nice and relaxing. Hope it was just what you needed to unwind and kickstart the weekend off right after a tough week of training, of exercise, working out. So leave me a comment. Let me know how you did, how you liked it, how it felt. And if you're happy that we're back to doing yoga again, I'm happy to be doing it again. I want to get back to really working on it. I worked on it a little bit over the holidays, but not the way that I had been previously. It was just like everybody else. I was super busy, you know? It happens. But we're going to get back into it now we've got time. All right. So leave me a comment. Like, subscribe, and share, and I will see you on jickityjack.com with a lot of great more workouts, great new workouts. I can't speak, it's fine. And I'll see you guys next time.